talking about. Morgan Freeman, thank you so much. They love you. I love you. We love you. Last time you were here, you very nice. You did a bit for us, a comedy bit, because you,
Sorry.
Is the water up to par?
Not water.
It's not water. Sorry, it's straight vodka. The last time you were here, we did a funny bit because you had done an interview. You did a film with Michael Caine, and you were doing an interview together, and he was talking, and you fell asleep during the interview. Oh, my goodness gracious. That was so funny. That was so funny, man. And you fell asleep during the interview. So anyways, I asked you, I ran into you, and I was like, would you come on the show and fall asleep during my monologue? And so you sat in the audience and you fell asleep during my monologue. You're a good man. Thank you for doing that. What is it about Michael Caine's...
Sorry, I did something wrong there. Sorry.
Morgan, did you... today, there was this guy, he's a great impressionist, a great comedian, Frank Caliendo. He does an impression of you.
Does he?
And he did an impression of you today reading LeBron James' letter for re-signing with the Cleveland Cavaliers. Have you seen this yet?
No.
It's fantastic. Let's roll a clip of this. Frank Caliendo.
Before anyone ever cared where I would play basketball, I was a kid from Northeast Ohio. It's where I walked. It's where I ran. It's where I cried.
Is that amazing?
You know you've arrived when people start doing impressions of your voice and people recognize which impression they're doing.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah, you're right.
Yeah. I'm here.
Exactly, yeah. I'm here. You can get me. I'll read the letter. Yeah, exactly, right? That's amazing. Isn't that wild?
Yeah, that's really.
I thought that was
really
unbelievable. Do you like when people do impressions of you?
No.
Okay. William, you... You live in Mississippi.
Yes.
I know a lot of things about you. I went to Wikipedia this afternoon. Okay. You live in a spaceship on Mississippi. No, you are in Mississippi, and I heard that you're a beekeeper. You keep bees?
Yes.
Is that... How long have you done that?
I just got them 2 weeks ago.
What? Two weeks ago?
I'm new at this.
Yeah, so you don't know how to do it yet. What do you do? What do you actually do stuff?
Well, they're new. They came from Arkadelphia, Arkansas.
Ooh.
So
imported bees.
Yeah.
Legally?
Legally. So they are out of their own environment. They don't know where the food is.
Ah.
So I have to feed them regularly.
So what do you feed them?
I feed them sugar and water.
Ah.
You give them 2 parts sugar, 1 part water, and put them in a feeder and put it into the hive.
Wow.
And what I've discovered is that I don't have to put on a bee suit or anything to feed them.
That's wrong. That's a rookie mistake. Yeah. You get stung by bees.
Never been stung.
You're going to get stung by a bee.
I'm never
going to
get
stung. You're
going
to get stung by a bee, Morgan. Please wear
stung.
A beekeeper outfit.
I'm not going to get
stung. You should even leave the house
there
wearing
a
beekeeper.
There was a beekeeper I know who was Jordanian. He never puts on a suit.
But
and
there's
he
something
said,
really,
because, you know, no.
Well, he has something
you
wrong
have
with
to
it.
Resonate.
You should always.
Jimmy.
Why do they have the outfits, Morgan?
They have the outfits for people who can't resonate.
You're at one with the bee.
Yeah.
You're at one with the bees.
Yeah. Okay. Yeah. Yeah. And plus I'm feeding them.
Exactly. They're not gonna bite the hand who feeds them. Thank you. Very smart.